Hi there, welcome to the D-Space Innovation Coffee Break. Today, I will talk about parking assistance systems using the output of ultrasonic sensors and how to test these systems. Ultrasonic sensors, you might think that's an old hat. Maybe not. If you think about more smart systems, like the parking steering control, like parking emergency brake, parking space localization, automatic park assistance, or even remote parking systems, then it becomes obvious that the ultrasonic sensor still plays a vital part in these systems. And furthermore, if you think about autonomous driving and to achieve level 3, 4, and 5, then it becomes even more clearer that we still need the ultrasonic signal to do the near-field supervision. Typically, the controllers merge the input now these days from surround view cameras with the output of these sensors. So, all in all, ultrasonic still plays a vital part here. How does this work? Actually, the controller sends out the ultrasonic pulse, fires the pulse, and then waits for the echo signal to return. It just measures the time of flight, knows the speed of sound at a certain temperature, and can calculate the object distance. Of course, there's much more going on, like triangulation, adaptive thresholds, all these things, but keep it simple for now. When it comes to testing these systems, we have four options. It could be a RESPA simulation, for instance, or it could be an interface where you inject the raw data directly into the controller. Or classic agile testing. Chop off a sensor, simulate the sensor, and try to simulate and mimic the bus communication there. The issue is, these days, that this information is just not disclosed anymore. It can be considered as proprietary information. So how to resolve that? We have the option 4 here. Option 4 is called over-the-air stimulation, which means we are integrating the real sensor and applying the echo signal directly to the sensor head, and then validate what the ECU is reading. The solution from DSpace has 4 degrees of freedom. We can manipulate the time of flight, which is clear, I guess, as the object distance is coded into the time of flight. But also, we can manipulate the frequency of the signal, the amplitude, and the pulse number. So this solution is meant to receive the real signal and send out the real signal. What we see here on this little screenshot is the reading of the AD converter on the DSpace side. So it reads the original signal sent out by the real sensor and the echo signal generated from on the DSpace side, from the DSpace transducer. So ideally, the echo signal should directly match the original signal just with a certain time delay, which represents the object distance. On the next slide, there is an example how the OTA, how we call it, the over-the-air stimulation, works for you. In this little example here, the OEM has specified certain levels in which the object distance should fall into. So let's assume we are going to simulate and stimulate the sensor with 60 or 70 centimeters. We could validate if the category is just what the OEM is expecting. So just, yeah, there is an object, yes or no, it's just really the information where the object is. How does this work in real? Let's have a look at the demo. Let's have a look now at the demo setup, which we have prepared. There is a DSpace lab box here with a processor board and the FPGA board with all the I/O modules required to connect all the sensors here, sitting down here. Here you have a sensor tray with 12 sensors. There is the DSpace sensor and transducer and the customer sensor. Customer, what does it mean? We have integrated a Bosch controller and a Valeo controller. The Bosch system supports reverse sensors, and the Valeo controller supports the front and the rear sensors. There's an HMI, which you find also in your vehicle. For the Valeo system, it's a display indicating the object distance to the front object and rear object. And on the Bosch system, there's a beeper and LED strips. For this little demo now, we have prepared four scenarios for testing the recognition of the object distance. So if the ECU reading the correct object distance. The first scenario is based on an interactive input of the object distance. So let's try first for the Valeo system. For the Valeo system, I'm going to apply now some distance here. Say, for instance, 50 centimeters, 30 centimeters, 20 centimeters. Ah, that's close. Let's return to 30. And do the same thing now on the reverse sensors. For instance, try 90 centimeters, 70, 50, 30, and hit the target. So, obviously, the ECU and the sensors are reading the correct signal over the air. Well, does this also work for the Bosch system? Let's try the Bosch system. The object distance is coded into the LED strip here, and you get also some audio feedback concerning the object distance read by the controller. So let's get closer now. Oh, that's close. Wow, that's close. There you go. This is the interactive input. However, you maybe want to automate such a sequence. One idea to automate a sequence is to apply a test pattern. Here we have specified some sinusoidal shape, and now we are going to simulate the object distance based on this shape. Let's try that. Now the object distance is coded according to the sinusoidal shape, and we are moving that object now closer. And now a little bit more far than before. Okay, seems to work. And off. Of course, we can also run a dynamic scenario. For the dynamic scenario, we have prepared a perpendicular parking maneuver. So let's try the parking maneuver. Now the vehicle is moving along the road, and the sensors on the front and rear are active, and the vehicle is scanning for parking space. Now, when some object is inside the scope zone of a sensor, it should be recognized and displayed on the HMI here. Now the car found some parking space, puts the gear into reverse. Well, there's an object. Should be also displayed here, of course. Continue your parking maneuver. Found a child within the scope zone of the sensor. And then finally finish your parking maneuver. But check for the object behind you, also shown here on the display. Okay. Stop it. Also, we have integrated the ISO maneuver. The ISO maneuver is a maneuver typically performed directly on the car, which means there is a 10 by 10 centimeters grid on the front of the car and on the rear of the car. And then there is a moving pole on the front and on the rear, just moving along the grid. And the object recognition is then validated within the car. Is the object, in this case a pole, recognized correctly? We can front load this testing activity directly into the lab. Let's try that and load the ISO maneuver on the front. Now it loads up the animations and the parameters for this maneuver. And in a second step, just wait for finishing it, start the maneuver. And what is going to happen is Now we have the pole here moving along the simulated grid. And now we should find the recognized object distance also on the HMI. And of course, you hear also the audio feedback. It's not necessarily replacing the testing on the vehicle, but at least you can save testing time moving this activity into the lab. Okay, seems to work. So that's all I wanted to show to you, the ultrasonic sensor stimulation over the air. If you need more on this, just get in touch with DSpace, and thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.
DSpace, your partner in simulation and validation.